If you ever wanted to go to Egypt to see real-life pyramids, mummies, sarcophagi, obelisks, and other ancient Egyptian treasures, but flying to Egypt may not be an option for you, well, you can get a taste of Egypt right here in Italy.
Welcome to Italy!
Hello, this is Simone. Join me on my new adventures on ARoadRetraveled. This week's episode is brought to you by the official ARoadRetraveled app for your iPhone, iPad Touch, and iPad. For above $99, not only you support our efforts to bring you more quality travel shows, but you get extra features only available on the app, like travel tips, bonus footage, photos, and more. Just search for ARoadRetraveled in the App Store and get yours today. Thank you, and happy travels! How did Italy get so lucky with such a vast assortment of ancient Egyptian artifacts, including the obelisks? Well, after the Romans conquered Egypt during the reign of Augustus in 30 BC, tourism just boomed. And not to mention the whole Cleopatra, Julius Caesar, and Mark Anthony scandals filling up the gossip papyrus, Egypt was quite en vogue. And wealthy Roman tourists were so impressed with Egypt's pyramids, obelisks, and artifacts that they just had to bring some home as souvenirs. And while they couldn't schlep to Rome, like the pyramids, they had them commissioned here to be built. Pyramids are what you expect to find only in Egypt, right? Wrong! Rome has its own ancient pyramid, thanks to one Egyptophile by the name of Gaius Chestius, a Roman magistrate who in 18 BC decided to build a tomb for himself, like the pharaoh he considered himself to be. The 72-foot-tall pyramid was built using brick-faced concrete covered with slabs of white marble on a travertine foundation. For all the work he put into immortalizing himself into posterity, by the Middle Ages, the locals attributed the pyramid to the tomb of Remus, with the tomb of Romulus, his brother and legendary founder of Rome, believed to have been another pyramid nearby that was built between the Vatican and Hadrian's mausoleum. Unfortunately for archaeologists and tourists everywhere, that pyramid was demolished in the 1600s. And probably use as spare parts for buildings in the area. It took Pope Alexander VII to set the record straight when he had a pyramid excavated in the 1660s and uncovered inscriptions and two bronze statues that Chestius' family had made. So now, Chestius can rest in peace. When the Aurelian Wall was constructed in 271 AD, the pyramid was incorporated into the walls to form a triangular bastion. Many other structures in Rome were used to form part of the new walls, probably to save on materials, labor, and time. The pyramid is easy to find. It's right next to the Piramide metro stop in the area of Testaccio, at the bottom of Aventine Hill. Another Egyptian symbol is the obelisk, and Rome is especially full of them. There are at least 8 ancient Egyptian obelisks that were originally from Egypt and taken to Rome after the Roman conquest of Egypt, and at least 5 obelisks that were either commissioned in Egypt by wealthy Romans and then shipped to Rome, or are Roman-made copies of Egyptian originals. And here are a few of the main obelisks you'll see gracing Rome's prominent piazzas and churches. In St. Peter's Square is the Vaticano obelisk that was originally raised in Alexandria, Egypt around 30 BC. It was brought to Rome by Caligula in 37 AD for the Spina of the Circus Vaticanus. Originally, this obelisk stood in what is now inside the Vatican, and it was moved to the center of the piazza in 1586. It's the only obelisk in Rome that hasn't toppled over since the Roman times. The cross on the top of the obelisk is said to symbolize Christianity's triumph over paganism. The largest standing ancient Egyptian obelisk in the world, and the tallest in Rome, can be found near the Basilica of St. John in Lateran. This 230-ton obelisk was brought to Rome in 357 from Alexandria's Temple of Amun in Karnak by Constantinus II to decorate the spina of Circus Maximus. Discovered in 1587, broken in three pieces, it was restored 4 meters shorter than its original height and erected in its present location, replacing the equestrian statue of Marcus Aurelius that was moved to the Capitoline Hill. In Piazza del Popolo, or the People's Square, stands the Flaminia Obelisk, and it was originally from Heliopolis, dating way back to Ramses II. It was brought to Rome by Emperor Augustus in 10 BC to be erected on the spina of Circus Maximus. The Macutia Obelisk graces Piazza della Rotonda, facing the Pantheon. It was originally one of the two obelisks at the Temple of Ra in Heliopolis and relocated to the Temple of Isis near the Santa Maria Sopra Minerva Church, not too far from the Pantheon. Discovered in 1373 near San Macutio Church, it was erected on a Capitoline Hill and then moved to the front of the Pantheon by Pope Clement XI in 1711 on top of the fountain. Back to the church of Santa Maria Sopra Minerva, you'll find a rather unique Egyptian obelisk that was erected on top of Bernini's Baroque elephant in front of a Gothic church that was built over the foundation of an ancient Roman pagan temple dedicated to Minerva, and hence the name Saint Mary over Minerva. The Agonalis Obelisk in Piazza Navona was erected on top of the Fountain of Four Rivers by Bernini in 1651. This, however, was a copy commissioned by Emperor Domitian to be erected at the Temple of Serapis in Alexandria. The dove on the top is a symbol of the Pamphili family of Pope Innocent X, who commissioned the fountain. Another famous square with its own obelisk is the Spanish Steps, or Piazza di Spagna. The Salustiano Obelisk is a smaller Roman copy of the Flaminia Obelisk in Piazza del Popolo that was built for the now deserted Gardens of Sallust around 1st century BC. Another important church with its own obelisk copy is Santa Maria Maggiore.